Pokemon use helium as a parchment to burn filled with blown tanks as Lox and RP1 are consumed by the Merle engines during ascent. Helium load began before the broadcast went live and will continue to top that off as well until about a minute and a half before launch. Andy mentioned that liquid oxygen being loaded, it's super chilled liquid oxygen, and to make sure the engine setup goes well, they perform engine chill. This began at T-minus 7 minutes, and a small amount of that LOX is flowed through the Merlin engine's turbo pumps to avoid thermal shock to that system, to allow the full flow of super-chilled liquid oxygen when the clock strikes zero. Dragon also began its startup sequence at T-minus 35 minutes when it coordinated timing with Falcon 9. It's currently undergoing vehicle health checks with the next big step happening just a moment ago when Dragon transitioned to internal power. What we're seeing on screen right now, the clap arms just underneath the Dragon began to open up, and they should be completing fully open right now. And the strong back, which is the truss structure right next to Falcon 9, is beginning to recline away to its pre-launch position, about 2 degrees away from the vehicle. It will continue to recline all the way back as we reach T0 to provide clearance for the vehicle to lift off.
And one lock load complete.
In these last few minutes, Falcon 9 is performing final health checks on its primary communications, avionics, and propulsion systems in preparation for flight. We also may hear calls that the engines are sufficiently chilled as we get closer to liftoff. The checkouts of the second stage thrust vector control actuators should begin right about T-minus 2 minutes 30 seconds. That's referred to as the engine wiggle test. A fairly self-explanatory name. This is where SpaceX will move the thruster nozzles slightly to make sure the guidance height is
correct.
The go for flight. SpaceX will do the exact same checkouts on the first stage engines just seconds before ignition. This is all still on track, weather being go now, for liftoff scheduled for 5:07:08 Eastern Time this morning, as we track towards the space station with a rendezvous and docking schedule for tomorrow morning. Space Station now tracking over Central Europe, and will be there with this mission for about a month.
this point, we are wrapping up liquid oxygen loading. Once that is done, that is all of the propellant loading onto the vehicles. And that is the collar right there. So all propellants are loaded onto the vehicle. We're starting to have some white clouds building around the vehicle that is condensed liquid oxygen. As that super chilled liquid oxygen reaches the warmer ambient air temperatures of Florida, it'll start to form those clouds. Normal and expected for us at this stage in the countdown. Let's continue to go smoothly as we march towards T0. At T-minus 1 minute, we'll get the Dragon transitioned to internal power core. The Falcon 9 computers will enter startup mode and begin final pre-launch checks. Guiding the rocket through the last seconds before liftoff. Both stages are now pressurizing for launch. Range remains good. The weather did clear earlier and has remained green. So all things
are good.
That's the launch director calling go for launch. We'll get an all systems go here in just a few seconds, and then we'll listen in to the rest of the call. was 40 seconds into flight. Falcon 9 and Dragon have orbiter emergency pass into the cloud layers right now. Next up, and in just a few seconds here, is Max Q. This is where the vehicle will experience the highest amount of aerodynamic pressures. Are going to be happening in rapid succession in about 15 seconds here. Successful main engine cutoff, followed by successful stage separation, and then ignition of our Merlin vacuum engine. On the left hand side of the screen, the first stage. Again, it's making its way back to Earth, but it's still being illuminated the second stage of Merlin vacuum engine there. So if you are just joining us, you're watching a live webcast for the 24th commercial resupply mission to the International Space Station for NASA. This is SpaceX's 31st mission for 2021 and the 5th Dragon flight to the International Space Station this year. Couple of views on the screen, the right-hand side of the screen is a view of the Merlin vacuum engine on the second stage. The Dragon capsule carrying all of the wonderful holiday treats and science is on the opposite end of that engine. Again, that is continuing to run smoothly as it makes its way to orbit. On the left-hand side of the screen is the first stage. You notice some honeycomb-like structures. There's two of them on screen right now. Those are hypersonic grid fins. They're positioned at the top of the first stage booster. There are four of them, actually. And those will start to swivel and move around to make sure that they are guiding the first stage back to its targeted landing zone. For today's mission, it's going to be the drone ship just reaping instruction, which is parked in the Atlantic Ocean. Next event for our mission today is going to be the first stage entry burn. It's going to be the first of two burns in order to make its way back to our drone ship. The first stage has to execute these two burns. The first, again, is the entry burn with three of our Merlin engines will reignite. This helps to slow the stage down as it re-enters the upper part of the Earth's atmosphere. The second burn is the landing burn. This happens about a minute later. This is a single engine burn that will bring the vehicle speed down rapidly in order to land on the drone ship. So again, the first stage has two burns before it can make its first landing attempt on our drone ship.